Last summer, I was in China to strengthen our relations and increase two-way trade for the mutual benefit of our citizens. I had a series of meetings on tourism, women's entrepreneurship, and small business. And at a particularly exciting event, Jack and I announced the launch of the Canada Pavilion on Alibaba. That was a great day for the Canada-China relationship, and more importantly, a great day for our citizens.
I know that our Prime Minister and Jack Ma both talked about the horizon, like down the road, 20, 30 years. Does Aldo have a vision for the company 20, 30 years down the line?
Absolutely, and I think that one of the things that Jack Ma said that really resonated with me as an Aldo employee, and that, you know, I think would really resonate with Aldo, is that he said entrepreneurs have dreams and big companies have KPIs. And if I look at Aldo, I think it's one of those few big companies that, yes, we have KPIs, but we've managed to keep the dream, and we've managed to keep those values of love, respect, and integrity. Aldo can resonate or can relate to Jack's vision of having a dream, even though we've become, you know, a large global company.
So we started in 2011. We're Toronto-based, and we believe in making wellness accessible to everybody, whether you're a beginner or you're an expert, because we wanted to try and make wellness simple.
What does or has the Canadian government done to support a Canadian business like yours?
One of the great things that Justin does is that he really supports free trade, and he wants to see the relations between Canada and China strengthen. And he's really enabling, working together with Jack, really enabling Canadian businesses to be able to sell in their platform and to have access to the Chinese market.
So tell me a little bit about that, you know, if you could compare and contrast that traditional storefront.
Yes.
Because you're no longer faced with that.
I think platforms like Tmall break all those barriers. You don't need to have a store. You don't need that distribution. You can instantly get distribution to new markets through platforms. And that's really changed the way people shop.
First of all, I mean, I think being rooted in Canada today in a world that has so much instability, and being a Canadian Marine is a fantastic asset, because, I mean, people love Canada from around the world. I mean, as far as the government, I mean, I would probably tie back maybe to what Jack Ma was saying this morning. You know, it's like making it easier to bring people to Canada. So as we think about building, you know, continuing to build a global organization where most of our people are based in Vancouver, continuing to have the ability to attract and retain talent is something that we're going to continue to focus on, because it's not always the easiest, but people do love coming to Vancouver.
And when it comes to trade with those two countries, with Canada and China, do you see any opportunity or greater opportunity in terms of regulation?
I think you always have opportunity when you listen to Justin Trudeau and Jack Ma this morning. I mean, it's like they're both big fans of globalization and free trade, and I think that's a continued opportunity. And I think that's a trend that's inevitable. So some parts of the world might slow it down, some other might accelerate it. Every one of our consumers around the world today is a global citizen. They know what's going on in North America, they see what's going on in Europe. And so, I mean, I think that globalization, especially when you think about like the advancements of technology and what we saw this morning with Alibaba, I mean, that level of transparency is happening very quickly everywhere.
Thank you. You're back again. Welcome, guys. Welcome to Gateway'17. My name's Icam, and yours is not.
When Canadian businesses are successful, it leads to more jobs for local communities and greater security for working families. That's why our government is so focused on innovation, progressive trade, and growing the middle class. We know that when our businesses and job creators prosper, so too does Canada.